You're listening to Release Your Resistance, episode 31. Welcome to Release Your Resistance. This is Bex. The only reason why any of us don't have what we want in life is because of our own resistance. Right now, I'm learning how to recognize and release my resistance, and this podcast tells you how you can release your resistance so that you can live the exact life that you want. Let's get started. Do you dream? Some people don't dream, but I dream a lot. And in the last couple of years, I have noticed that I am really great at interpreting dreams, and I love interpreting dreams, my own and other people's. So today I want to teach you how to interpret dreams. I'm going to share with you my three-step process that you can use to interpret dreams, either your own or somebody else's. And I'm going to give you a few examples of dream interpretations just to kind of illustrate my three-step process and so you see how to apply it. Plus, I think it's kind of interesting. I'm going to share one of my actual dreams with you and show you how I made the interpretation of it. And then I want to give you some specific ways that you can use your own dreams and your own dream interpretations to figure out what you're thinking and figure out what you're dreaming about and see what's going on in your brain. The whole purpose of this podcast episode is because I want to inspire you to dream, like actually have those dreams at night while you're asleep. And then I want you to remember your dreams when you wake up the next morning. And I want you to take the step of interpreting your own dreams. You might be listening thinking, okay, well, this episode isn't for me because I'm one of those people who don't dream. If that's the case, if you don't dream or you can't remember your dreams when you wake up, that's okay. This episode is still for you because I know you know people who dream and who sometimes tell you, I had the craziest dream last night. So I want to share this information with you so that you can consider it when you hear other people talking about their dreams, and maybe you'll consider interpreting their dreams. And this also might just awaken your subconscious. It might just open your mind just enough so that you can actually start dreaming, or so that you will remember your dreams when you wake up. I'm excited to hear. I mean, I'm actually kind of betting on if there's anyone listening right now who thinks that they don't dream or can't remember their dreams, I'm kind of betting on this episode helping them to wake up to a dream sometime in the near future. So the first thing I want to go over with you is my three-step process to how to interpret your dreams. It is pretty simple, and I think you can implement this for yourself. The first thing you're going to do is record the details of the dream, and then you will list out each element in the simplest form from your dream. And finally, the third step is when you finally get to the interpretation. The third step is when you consider the meaning and reference from the dream. Let's dig in deeper to the three steps. The first step, write down everything that you remember. And if you recall a moment ago when I was telling you the three steps, I told you the first step is to record the details of the dream. Maybe you literally thought I meant record. What I really meant is write it down. But you don't have to write it down with a pen and paper if you don't want to. You could dictate it into your phone, into a notes app. But the point is, this is the time in step one, as soon as you can after waking up, just get everything from the dream down in writing. So when I said record, I didn't actually mean like record a voice memo. That's not going to help you for this step. You're writing down everything that you can remember about the dream. And you're not interpreting it yet. You're not making anything in the dream mean anything else, and you're not worried about anything in the dream. So if the dream had some element that's scary or depressing or sad, this is not the time to worry or think about any of that. Right now, we're just getting all of the details, all of the language. So if you heard any speaking, if there were any words said or written in the dream, you would want to collect those. Any images that you saw, how you felt. If you woke up realizing that you feel really sad because of what happened in the dream, notice the emotions. So you just want to collect all of the details from the dream and get them down in writing. And you keep writing until you cannot remember a single other detail about the dream. So be prepared. This can actually take a while because the more you write out the details, the more details will come back to you. Be prepared. You might be writing for a while. You might end up with a few paragraphs, and that's all good. Collect all the details, all the images, all the verbiage, all the feelings, all the events, whatever happened in the dream. You want to get it all out in writing so that you can look at it, so that you can see it. And once you've got the entire dream written down, now you can move on to step two. So step two is to list each element in its most simple form. So remember back in math class when our teachers told us, write everything in the lowest common denominator, right? Reduce everything to its simplest form. That's what we're doing with every element of the dream. So we look back at the description that you wrote and you start pulling each element out, and you're just making a list, a bulleted list. So you could easily have, depending on how much you remember from your dream, 20 items in a list. Again, we're not at the stage of making any interpretations or translations or guessing any meanings at this point. We're not worried if there was something like a rushing river or a killer on the loose or a fire, anything. We're not worried about anything at this stage. We're just neutrally and non-judgmentally listing out every single element into the list while we're in step two. I actually wanted to recount one of my dreams so that I can give you an example of how this would look. A couple of months ago, I woke up and realized I had had a dream the night before. I did step one, which is I recorded the entire dream in all of its detail as much as I could remember. And here's what I recorded. I was a kid or a teenager living at home with my parents, and the power went out. So we didn't have any running water in our house. And we wondered, how are we going to do our homework? The next morning, I realized there was still no running water. So I wanted to pull my hair up and I grabbed a hairpin, but I had trouble gathering all of my hair together. It wouldn't stay together in the pin. And as I was looking in the mirror because I was working on my hair, I noticed some spore-type flowers on the front of my head. And I touched one of the flowers and it dissolved into pieces. And so then I had to lean my head over the trash and comb out all of those flowers that were growing from or stuck on my head. I don't know. So that was the dream. Sounds pretty dreamy, right? Like maybe you have had dreams like that where things don't necessarily seem to jive next to each other and doesn't really make a lot of sense. But notice, this is not the time yet where we're going to try to make sense of it. This is not the time yet where we're interpreting it. We've just recorded everything. So we've got our record of the dream, step one complete. Now we list out each of the elements in the most simple form. So here is my list from the dream that I just told you about. Teenager living at home. Power went out. Question. How could I work? Phrase. Once I realized, pulling my hair up using a clip, my hair wouldn't stay together. Spores in the hair. Dissolved, put in trash. Okay, so see how I have a whole list of elements from the dream, still not trying to interpret, still not trying to assign any meaning to what I was thinking about or why those elements came to me in the dream. Now we're at step three. This is finally when we can consider meaning and reference. I really want to point out here, we're not assigning meaning literal. Like this is not a literal translation, but you can think of it as like a translation, right? Think of it as something in one language. What does it mean in another language? What is the word for this in this other lexicon or in this other world? What does this represent? We're more asking, what is this a metaphor for? If you do have anything that's really gross or shocking, or a person in your dream that you really wish you weren't dreaming about, it doesn't mean that literally you care about that person or that person's in your life or should be in your life. I've talked to and heard examples of a lot of people who seem to have dreams about their exes, like an ex-husband or an ex-partner or a former coworker, former boss. Just because you're dreaming about that person who is no longer part of your life, it is not your subconscious telling you that for some reason that person needs to be in your life again. We're not making a literal meaning from someone showing up in your dream. We're just considering what it might mean or what it might represent. And we're noticing emotions in two different ways. We're noticing emotions from during the dream, like, were you scared in the dream? Were you excited in the dream? Were you impatient in the dream? And then once you're in step three here and you're interpreting the dream, you're also noticing your conscious emotions and thinking about the activities in the dream. For example, if you did have a dream about an ex and in the dream there was no drama and there was no anger towards the ex, but when you wake up there's a lot of anger that you saw that ex in your dream, you just should notice the difference in the emotion from while you were in the dream and now that you're awake, because you can interpret both of those emotions from the two different perspectives. You also need to get over any weirdness. We've all heard the classic dream of someone showing up to school naked. Maybe that seems kind of weird and uncomfortable for you. Just get over any weirdness out of any dream. If you have a dream about having sex with your coworker, do not make it mean anything weird. Just use what I'm telling you to interpret what that dream might be, what you're thinking about. And it doesn't have to literally mean that you're thinking of having sex with a coworker. It can mean a lot of different things based on context and the reference, like what you're thinking about, what's going on in your life. So let me give you some examples of when I'm talking about meaning and reference. From the dream example that I gave you earlier, the way that I interpreted it, when I realized one of the elements in the dream was that I was a teenager living at home, I took the translation of that, not literally, like I didn't think, oh, should I move back in with my parents? Like, am I acting juvenile? No, I didn't take it literally. I just thought, what does a teenager living at home represent? What are the qualities of a teenager living at home? And to me, it meant feeling new and young and fresh-faced, right? Ready for the world, but also not yet independent. Do you see how I took the meaning of something and I didn't make it mean what it literally meant, but I translated it into something that I think most of us would agree, a teenager living at home feels new and but is still young and not yet independent. I took the element of the power going out as powerless. I mean, that's a direct translation right there. If you have no power, there's no power in your house, it's powerless. The question that I had asked myself in the dream, like I was wondering, well, how am I going to work if there's no power? How am I going to do my homework? That I translated to mean, I don't know how to proceed. The statement that I made, I woke up the next morning and I realized that to me equals acceptance. I realized, I accepted, I saw. And then when I was trying to pull up my hair using a hair clip, I translated that to mean control. Control what I can. And I use a found resource. And then the fact that the hair wouldn't pull up, it wouldn't stay together in the clip, I translated that to mean it's not easy. And things don't always go as we hope for. Finally, the spores in my hair were irritants, literally. Like if you had flowers or leaves or seeds or something in your hair, that would be irritating and it would probably itch you. So I made those mean irritants. They were on my head, irritants on my head, thoughts about myself. And then I was able to discard them because in the dream, as I touched them, they dissolved and they fell into the trash. I caused them to fall into the trash. So see how I took each element, I translated it on its own with a little bit of reference or a little bit of context to what was going on in the dream, but I didn't make any literal translations. And now I have a new narrative. Now I have my dream interpretation. What that dream was about was that I was, or if I was talking about in present tense, the morning after the dream, I am feeling new and fresh face, and I don't yet feel independent. In fact, I might feel powerless and I might ask or say, I don't know how to proceed. But once I accept that, once I see it, once I realize it, I can control things with some resources that I find or with a found resource. But it won't be easy. Things don't always go as I hope for. And I might have irritating thoughts about myself, little thoughts that are bothersome. But when I touch them, I am able to discard them. What? That is like a direct analogy for what was going on for me at the time in my life. So it was exactly at the point that I was starting my coaching practice. Of course, I felt new. And of course, I would at times feel powerless and not fully independent yet and not know how to proceed. And once I accept that and see it for what it is, I can look for resources and can try to control things with the awareness I can't control things and things will still go wrong. And all of that comes from my own thoughts that I can choose to keep or discard. It makes perfect sense. I hope you see that too. So I want to give you a few more examples of some dream interpretations in case your dreams are a little bit different from the example that I just gave you. If you wake up tomorrow morning and you have had a dream about snakes, first of all, it might be because you heard me talking about snakes on this podcast right now. And so that might be in your consciousness and might come up in the dream tonight, totally normal. But when you think about snakes, the first things that I popped into my mind when I thought, okay, if I had a dream and there were snakes in it, or you were telling me about your dream and you mentioned the snake or the snakes in the dream, I would immediately start thinking, what does a snake represent? What are the qualities or characteristics of a snake? A reptile, cold-blooded. A snake sheds its skin. Depending on the cultural references or what the person, like how the person was raised or where they grew up or what their access to different parts of the world's literature might be, they might think of like a snake charmer. That's interesting. Like controlling the snake and willing the snake. Or they might think of like the snake from the Adam and Eve story, right? The snake being like a temptation or like a bad influence. So when I was interpreting a dream and a snake came up, based on the context and based on the person, what I felt the meaning was transformation. The snake represented shedding the skin, leaving that old behind, and moving towards the new. To me, in that dream, this specific dream that I was interpreting, and she mentioned snakes, based on everything else, I was able to say, okay, I think that's about you leaving behind the old, being done with the old, and moving forward into the new, into your new existence, your new life. Another example I've heard people have, and this is one's really interesting, because people have said that they have dreams where they're giving birth, like they're actually birthing, delivering a baby, even if they're not a parent or a mother. And they're like, I don't even know why I would dream about this. I don't have children. I've never had children. I don't want children. But here I had a dream about giving birth, like the whole process of it and the feeling of it, the imagery of giving birth. And so what I make that mean is it could be about, doesn't have to be literally about a baby. It could be about a new project or a new creation. It could be about the idea of wanting to nurture something, wanting to take care of something in its infancy and watch it grow. Isn't that so interesting that if you end up having a dream about giving birth or taking care of a baby, it might not have anything to do with children at all. It might be about something that you're doing at work or in your life, or it might be about a hobby or something like that. A lot of people have talked about waking up from dreams and noticing that in the dream, I was revisiting or reliving past events. Now, these could be either mundane, going back to a former workplace that you're like, what was I doing back in that former workplace? Or like in my example that I gave you, being back at home as a teenager, so reliving past events. This could also bring up upsetting events, like things that might have even caused you some trauma. So when you dream about reliving past events, either the mundane or the upsetting, you can again check in to see what does that place or person or event represent. And we talked a little bit before about how dreaming about an ex doesn't necessarily mean that you're interested in seeing or talking or thinking about that ex again. So if you have a dream and your ex is one of the main characters in the dream, you could actually substitute that out and say, well, the ex represents a partner, right? So you don't, when you interpret the dream for yourself and you say, okay, my ex was walking towards me, you might interpret that to mean like, I saw my partner coming towards me. Ooh, that would be really interesting if you are currently single and interested in a new relationship. Dreaming about your ex coming towards you does not mean that you need to get back with the ex. It could tell you that you are thinking subconsciously about a new partner coming towards you, a partner, maybe even someone you know, maybe the ex, probably not. It doesn't even have to represent a person or that person. It could represent you. So who were you when you were with that person? If you dream about an ex, maybe it's talking about you in that context. Just like the example that I gave you earlier, the dream when I was a teenager living at home with my parents wasn't really even about my parents. It was really about me feeling not yet independent and me feeling new. So the casting of my parents in the dream was more to put me in context. It wasn't really about the other people. If you are dreaming about or continuing to dream about an upsetting or traumatic event, it might be because subconsciously you might blame yourself for not knowing or not stopping it. So this might be your mind's way of replaying the incident over and over again. So if there was an event that you currently think shouldn't have happened in the past, it's very possible that you will dream about it frequently, even maybe, because your mind might not be on board that it happened, but it did happen. But your mind might think, but it shouldn't have happened. I should have known. I should have been able to stop it or predict it or change the course of it. So your mind might bring that back to you while you're asleep, hoping that you can relive it, do it differently, see it differently. That might be an indication that you blame yourself, maybe subconsciously, for not knowing that the relationship was going to end, let's say, or not being able to stop, let's say, the death of a loved one, right? If you have some kind of subconscious blame that you're giving yourself, your dream about that might be a way for you to process that. And so knowing that, having awareness about it, interpreting it, and thinking about it the next morning is so helpful because then you have awareness around it. Reliving past events might be your brain giving you away an offer to try a do-over, at least in your subconscious, at least while you're asleep. Maybe the brain just really, really wants a chance to do it over again and do it differently or try a different way. Those were the three steps. You record the dream, you list out all of the elements, and then finally, that's when you look at meanings and interpretations and translations. So once you've done that, and just like I gave you the example, you can give yourself, read yourself that new narrative once you've done the interpretation, then what? How can you use this? Well, first of all, it's interesting, right? So that's just fun, just for entertainment value. You can also use your dream interpretations as a jumping off point of questions that you could consider for yourself, for journaling and self-coaching, or even if you work with a coach. I've heard of people bringing their dreams to their therapy sessions to work through with their therapist. Remember that your dreams are your subconscious offering a little peek, right? Accept that offer. Accept the awareness of what your subconscious is thinking and replaying and wondering about and asking about. Another thing that I really like to do with my interpreted dreams, I like to come back later, a week later, a month later, a year later, and reinterpret the dream description. So this is why, again, it's very helpful to do the three steps that I mentioned in that order and as separate steps. Because if I write out the whole paragraph of the dream, I'm able to come back later and just read that paragraph with fresh eyes without reading any of the interpretation or meanings. And I can see if my mind 6 months later offers a different explanation or a different thought about the dream. Because think about it, by then I will have had 6 months of perspective. I will have seen how it all played out. So that'll be really interesting to be able to look back with perspective, with more maturity, with more development, and reinterpret the dream description and see if it meant anything else. You should let your conscious, intentional thoughts about the dream be what guides you and what you make decisions by. So don't just latch on to the very first interpreted idea and run with it. If I had made it mean that I need to move back in with my parents because I had a dream about being a teenager living at home with my parents, that would have been like my first interpreted idea. But instead, what I want to do is let my conscious, intentional thoughts guide me and make decisions. So I can intentionally interpret that dream to mean, I feel like I'm new. I feel like I'm not fully independent yet. I feel a little bit powerless. Then intentionally, I can ask myself, what could I do to make myself feel powerful? What could I do to give myself some power? Like maybe in my case, that might be finding resources, finding a coach, finding a mentor, trying things, getting help. So these are all things I could do with intentional thoughts based on my dream interpretation. And check in to see if the thoughts in the dream are being offered by your inner voice or by your ego. So in other words, are the thoughts in the dream coming from love and abundance, or are the thoughts in the dream coming from fear and scarcity? Either way, good to know. It's really good to know either way. Doesn't mean anything is wrong if you wake up and realize, I just had a dream out of complete scarcity. Wow, I would really like to know that. Because if that is what my subconscious is producing for me while I sleep, you can bet that those thoughts are also humming along in the background while I'm awake. And I would much rather know about those and address those thoughts than just let them to continue running on autopilot behind me. So there's just a few other loose ends and disclaimers that I want to offer you before we wrap up here today. Context and emotion is so important. So you can interpret each element of the dream on its own, but just like I mentioned with the snake example, if you know the context, either your own or who the friend or stranger, even whose dream you're interpreting, it's really helpful to know, okay, so this isn't so much about feeling tempted, like in the snake example, this is much more about losing the old and moving into the new, like a snake shedding its skin. Good to know, right? So really think about the context and what emotion is accompanying the elements in the dream. Remember, outside influences definitely affect your dream. So we've been talking about snakes now. You might dream about snakes tonight. If you watch a show or read a book before you go to bed, or if you've been watching the show for the last couple of nights and you've been seeing those characters over and over again, night after night, it's likely that you could dream about the characters. It's likely that you could dream about something from the book or the show. If you had a conversation with someone, that could pop up in your dream. And I've experienced this, and maybe you have too, certain foods and drinks like alcohol could impact your dreams. So just keep those in mind when you're interpreting your dreams. If something's really different or something seems kind of out there, it's all coming from all of the different inputs. It's what you watch, it's what you say, it's what you experience, plus it's everything that's in your mind. And I just can't underscore this enough. Your dreams are not literal. If you dream that you're having a baby in your dream, it does not mean that you are pregnant. Don't worry about that. Your dreams are also not prophetic. So if you dream about a car accident, it doesn't mean you're going to get in a car accident. It's not predicting the future. Dreams are just your thoughts, your subconscious thoughts while you're asleep. As we were talking about with reliving past events, your recurring dreams might imply some kind of cognitive dissonance. If you keep on being offered these thoughts while you're sleeping, there might be something that's kind of dissonant in your own mind. Like you think something should have happened one way, but it happened another way. So your brain might be offering you the option to revisit it or make sense of it while you're asleep. I really recommend that you keep a dream journal because, like I said, it's so helpful to reinterpret your dreams later and see things from a different or a wider perspective. Now, when I say keep a dream journal, I don't mean that you have to have a separate dedicated journal just for your dreams. Although if you want to, totally support that, that's fine. I keep all of my dreams in my regular journal. It's all mixed in there together. And sometimes I'll note on the side of the page that this was a dream. So if I'm curious about dreams I've had in the past, I can flip through and look for that notation on the side of the page to see the dream. And then I really want to recommend that you find a dream buddy. You might have experienced this, or this might even be you who I'm about to describe. There are some people who do not care about dreams. They don't want to talk about dreams. They don't want to hear about dreams. They don't have dreams. They don't care. And that might be your partner or you. So that person is not your dream buddy. If you're like me and you delight in your dreams, you're curious about your dreams, you want all of your dreams interpreted, you want to talk about your dream interpretations with other dream fans, find a dream buddy. I will be your dream buddy. I love talking about this kind of stuff. I love interpreting dreams. So find someone or even a small group of people who, a person or people who you can tell your dream to and get insight or get tips on how you could interpret it. It'll make it so much more interesting. So I hope I have inspired you to dream and to remember your dreams. And then the next morning, to interpret your own dreams. And now I am curious, what do you think about dream interpretation now? Have I missed anything? Did I get anything wrong? Are you in total disagreement with one of my pieces of advice or one of my cautions about dream interpretation? Do you have any resistance to recording and translating your own dreams? I really want to know your input and your feedback. Send me an email at hi@bexby.org. Or let me know in a comment in the show notes at bexby.org/dreams. And if you are one of my favorites, of course, I want to offer you the opportunity to have me interpret one of your dreams. So in the email this week, I sent you this episode along with a link to a Google form where you can write out your dreams and I'll take a stab at interpreting it for you and see what you think. If you have a dream 2 weeks from now, come back to this email and find it and send it to me. If you're not one of my favorite people yet, I hope you will become that person by going to bexby.org/favorites and giving me your email address. And then every week I will send you one or sometimes two emails and you'll get every episode plus all the fun extra things that I send to all of my favorite people. And next week, I want to talk to you about journaling and hopefully help you along on your journal journey. Is that hard to say? On your journal journey. So I can't wait to tell you my love affair with journaling. You've probably already heard about it. If you've been ever talked to me, you've probably heard about journaling. And I want to tell you all about it next week. Okay, thank you so much for listening. And I will talk to you later. Bye-bye. This has been Release Your Resistance. Thank you for listening. If you like this podcast, make sure you're subscribed and leave a review on Apple Podcasts. Also, think about someone who you know who would love this episode and share it with them. There should be a share button on your app if you're listening to this on your phone. If you'd like to continue this conversation one-on-one or in real time, come visit me on my site at bexby.org to see how we can work together.